Oh, far, far away. From beyond the eyes, hills and plains, the world of sad is seen. Just tell your shipmates I'm taking a trip, mates, and I'll see you someday on Fiddler's Green. And when you're in love and alone in this room, there's clubs and there's pubs and there's lassies there too. Well, the girls are all pretty and the beer is all free, and there's bottles of rum growing on any tree. Wrap me up in the eyes, skins and blankets, no more on the dark side of the sea. Just tell the old shipmates I'm taking a trip, mates, and I'll see you someday on Fiddler's Green. Now I don't want the harp nor a halo on me, just give me a breeze and a good rolling sea, and I play the old squeeze box as we sail along with the wind and the rigging to help me out strong. Wrap me up in the oilskins and blankets, no more on the docks I'll be seen. Just tell the old shipmates I'm taking a trip, mates, and I'll see you someday. Just tell the old shipmates I'm taking a trip, mates, and I'll see you someday.
There's devil the one and this time long was clean and rare than me. And I'm living in Thronester in Clavon to the name. My dad lived up in Carmen. He kept a sermon boy. His second wife was very sharp. He very tore my joy. Now she was thin, her nail was thin.
and L is for the lake where I first met my old colleague. A is for angels who are watching over you. N means never frown, he's smelling truth. And D is for your daddy's blessing, and I hope it will be a blessing. That's how I spell.
Yeah. Thank you. Well, you go and you'll sing to me.
Forget about it.
You'll sing us off.
Yeah.
I'm out.
That's
it. Right, then, Gerard Amalin.
Just
Instead of cooking the chicken, we're putting on the proper way to bathe your baby. This no doubt will help some of you young mothers. So over now to our announcer for the evening, Miss O'Reilly.
Good evening, ladies.
Which programme was for our
I do hope that you're all well and looking forward to our informative chat together.
Indeed we are.
You would need some lukewarm water.
Lukewarm water.
Give it a little kiss. Coochie? Rocket to and fro. Gently now, gently. And that, ladies, is the proper way to bath your baby.
Bath your baby? I thought this was the cooking a chicken.
When you were sweet,
for he already drank his beer. He recited wondrous stories of his exploits far and near. Singing Irish songs and telling, best of order, one and all. Then for he already sang for them the hills of Donegal. There was cheering at the finish, and the call and roar and roar. Moriarty said, listen lads, can't sing any more. So he stood there sad and silent, gazing to his beard. And in his eyes they glistened, starting off a tear. Are you going home for Christmas? The kindly barmaid said. Moriarty fixed his ears and roar, and slowly shook his head. Sure, I haven't been to Ireland now, this 20 years or more. Sure, my mother would hardly know me if I walked up to the door. I was born, said Moriarty, on an island of the west, the last place God created, but the first place that he blessed. We were poor, but we were happy in our simple little ways. My God, I wish you were a boy again to live my youthful days. My father, God be good to him, was drowned one woeful night. And my mother left all nonsense, and myself were working fine. So I don't arrive at McCarthy, came across to England to earn a nun's pay. I told my dear old mother I'd suit my turn again. But the curse of drink came over me and enslaved me in its tears. So I haven't been to Ireland now, 'tis 20 years or more. But I know she's still there waiting for my footsteps at the door. Then someone started singing, singing in the winter snow. It was like an old bell ringing, far away and long ago. Moriarty stood and listened, then pushed his glass away, and he made a solemn promise he'd go home for Christmas Day. He saved up every penny he could get into his hand, and coming up to Christmas, he saved for Ireland. His heart was filled with gladness. He felt content at last as the train rolled through the Midlands and brought him to the west. In the village of Kinsheila, that lay upon the shores, far across the big blue waters, he saw his island home once more. The stars were shining brightly, sure they glistened like a dome. On that little whitewashed cottage was Moriarty's home. 'Tis a grand night for the say goodbye. Tides are walking away out of sight. Now I regret sleeping off my plan. Well, I'll dream again as you branch in.
Thank you.